Hello everyone, welcome back to another volleyball tutorial video. My name is Cody Reinsma, and today I will be teaching you the jump float serve. Conversely, an earlier video that we did, we covered how to jump top a serve. This is different from the float serve as the jump top more focuses on power and a drop on the ball, while the float serve focuses on the movement of the ball and the placement. It is a little slower of a serve, but it can still be quite effective. Now the serve is seen in almost all levels, from the international all the way down to some of the youngest levels. The serve is more commonly used in women's volleyball, opposed to men's, who focus more on the jump serve. So we're just gonna jump right into it and show you how it's done. Here we go.
To begin the float serve, you will first need to learn the footwork and toss. The footwork and toss are linked as you perform the toss while doing the footwork. The footwork for the float serve is left, right, left. This is the same footwork as with the topspin serve. Your first two steps of left then right should be normal size steps, while your final step of the left is a more baby-like step. As you take your first step with your right, toss the ball into the air using both hands. This brings us to the toss itself. For the float serve toss, using both hands, place them on the bottom of the ball in a bowl-like manner, using your thumbs to support the side, while the rest are holding the ball on the bottom. When you toss, be sure that the toss is as still as possible in the air. Linking these together, take your first step, toss, then proceed with your last two steps quickly. As you toss the ball forward in front of you so that the ball is lined up with your leading shoulder when you jump to contact it.
Now, for the arm swing, as I mentioned earlier, you want the ball to be landing in front of your leading shoulder. Since I'm a righty, it's my left. If you're a lefty, it's your right. Now, as I toss, when I toss, the ball should be at my hitting point. That is the highest point that it will reach. And I should be contacting the equator of the ball once again. If you can't get above the net, then you're gonna wanna contact just a tad lower on the ball, but not too much, otherwise it will go soaring out. As you hit the ball and you hit the equator, it should be up here, and driving your hips into the ball, like so. Your hips and your arm all swing in the same motion. As you swing, come from your Zeus position here, as we showed in the topspin video. Rotate, flat hand, forward, then down along your side. Never should you be taking your arm and cutting across your body. That is bad for your shoulder, and it will mess up your float. So as you swing, contact, forward, and down. The forward motion right here is going to give you the float serve. And what that does, makes the ball move back and forth in the air while keeping it so it doesn't have spin. So, like so, here, contact, forward and down your side.
To aim your serve, when you want to go straight down the line, be sure to rotate your arm only along your side and keep your shoulders square to the net. If you wish to serve to the middle, cross your arm the slightest degree so that your fingers end pointing toward the middle of the court. If you want to serve all the way across to the left, rotate your torso so that you are squared with the place you want to serve. A good rule of thumb is that wherever your fingertips end up pointing is where the ball will go. Be aware that when you serve, you may have a loose spin on the ball because of micro adjustments of your hand. This is fine, as some spin will still allow the ball to float and possibly curve.